we have a 48 inch tow behind aerator from Red Rock. Got it at Princess Auto. Just gonna assemble it today. Basically, the shaft is shorter on one end than the other, and you want this hub to face that short end of the shaft. So we slide that on like that. M8 hex lock nut and M8 by 30 bolt. Put that through like that. This is a 1/4 inch by 1 9/16 inch bolt. And this is the 1/4 inch lock nut. I'm just going to loosely assemble stuff and then tighten it up once I get going here. So I want to make sure the flat part here is to the short end, like that. Then a long spacer goes in. And then the second set of tines. Big flat washer at the very end. The 2.36 inch spacer slides on. Then we need another full tooled flat washer. Then we need this unit. And it goes facing same way as the bushing on this. Side of this plate like that. 2.95 inch spacer tube goes next. Then my tines like that. It's looking good. And a 5.31 inch spacer tube. Boom. Spacer. Put this next set of knives on, like so. And 1 inch spacer and O2O washer. Make sure this is facing the opposite way. So this had fallen off when I pounded from the other end. So spacer, washer, teeth facing in, tongue facing in. 10 hex bolt. You take your bolt, slide it into the wheel, gets another washer on the back, and then the non-locking nut spins on. Just like that. Use adjustables and we're going to tighten this up. It's an M8 by 25 bolt and an M8 locking nut. That goes on top like that. I'm going to drop the hitch pin and the cotter pin here just so that I know it's all lined up. Because that thing was wiggling crazy when I... Just make sure that's not crooked, that it's fairly straight on there before you give it the final tighten. Okay, that's good. To assemble the tray, these nibs go to the front, so backwards. You slide the hitch assembly towards me like that. There's 8 holes there. There's 2 spacers like that. So M8 by 30, 2 spacers. M8 by 25, and then M8 by 30 with 2 spacers. Make sure that this is in line. Final tight. Uh-oh. Top's on backwards. Have to spin the top for it. Slide the handle down in here. And you can see the bolt here we put in earlier. We're going to take the nut off. Larger hole on the bracket than the bolt, so the bolt will actually rattle around. So they included the spacer to tighten things up. So it goes like that. The bolt head goes through like that, and then we can fire the nut on it. Yeah, make sure that's nice and lined up. This is actually pretty good. You should always tighten the bolts after a few uses too, because they'll jiggle loose. So I think we're done.